Snooker Road. And the Canadian captain having at it, Adam Fantilli, the Canadian captain there. Here we go.
Doing well just to hold the line there. Fantilli could have got offside. Savoie, big contact. And there you're seeing Savoie, who loves to get involved. And it is very interesting, and it will be, to see who can control their discipline here early.
Wide shot there off of the stick of Jovanovic. And Canada with the early possession. U.S. had a huge start against Finland. Tristan Luno. Canada coming back. Looking for that first little crease. First opportunity. We're looking for the goalie to make
to get on with their work.
Face off. We're about 3 minutes in. Not much between the two. Canada's had a little bit of the territorial advantage. I haven't seen it. You don't want to give the Canadians an extra man.
That's a good face-off win for Canada. They're looking just a little bit more diligent than they had done in their opening matches. That overwhelming start for Russia against them really
looked
out
of sorts. Right in front, a chance! Oh, and a save, and that was Silverstein locked on right away.
It's a great shot from Fantilli, and Silverstein makes the save and earning his keep for getting that nod in this match.
USA looking more unsettled than we've seen them yet. Chasing a bit. But when they get the puck, which they don't, again, right in front, joining the play.
And to get this whistle and a faceoff.
Cruz Lucius, one of the great names of the tournament, would like to have that look. But number one has been answered. Can Canada raise their level? Yes, they have. Now the question for the U.S. is, can they reassert? Not played poorly here.
This opening half of the opening of this period, it's encouraging for the Canadian prospects.
All the way around and out. Canada taking chase. That extra hustle creating an opportunity down there. And that's Nate Danielson, 19, doing the good grinding. Now the U.S. with a chance on a bad drop pass. It's a 3-on-1. Canada coming in. Can they take something away early?
Mistake of it. They have found their level in this game. They've not been at this pace so far in this tournament. Now
what a setup here. Turn around, he lets it go, and again, stick to side. Fillion seeing the puck very clearly.
Now you can feel a little bit of a momentum change, and that the U.S. right now have picked up the pace. Oh, what a hit there. That's Charlie Strammel.
Right in front of the official, and Strammel has been in the penalty box in day one, and another chance right there. But here comes Canada trying to even the surface a little bit. That attempt to get by Lane Hudson doesn't work. The U.S. starting to become a little more physical. And look at Hudson battling. Not a big man, but... And here comes the U.S. They had a little bit better than they got there. Oh, the pickup. And it's Hunter Grustovitz doing the good work. That was an on, almost a tuck in there, but Silverstein
to just tuck it in. It's nothing doing.
Here we go. Under 3.5 to go. This has been end-to-end quality hockey. It's been physical, it's been clean, and now a possible 2-on-1. Snuggerud lets it go, and it's blocker saved, but barely. That was up in the air.
He had great speed and power on that, directed for that top left corner.
Regrouping. We haven't seen the explosion from the U.S. that we've seen through the first two games. They've started to improve the buzz now and get some chances, but
you know what's happened before you can respond, and it's the element of surprise a little bit with the USA.
Chance right in front, it's still on the doorstep. Fillion saw it, the US didn't. 2-on-3, minute to go. Back and away, and knocked away by Silverstein, but it's still in danger territory.
And that's you're too good a player, and he gave him a little bit of a chatting to it. It was probably the right way to manage it by the referee.
50 seconds to go, a lot of time, and then the steal by Snuggerud. Gives it away, though.
in a while, but this lineup here with Danielson out here has had a noticeable period. More of a presence, Danielson, number 19 in this game so far.
And Tilly dumping it back in, period winding down. Can Canada get some bottled magic here in the last 10 seconds? It's 5-4 and 3, and they let it go, and the period will...
Now against some of the other best players in the world. So you're just at another level right now, and it takes some time, and you're going to have some growing pains out there live in play.
First bit of adversity for Team USA, starting period number two. They have to kill the penalty. Chance right in front. On! I believe that Silverstein got a piece of that.
Well, it's an outstanding save. It's more important than it looked, the way he takes that glancing effort coming in from Matthew Savoie.
U.S. maintaining the box, diamond alternation there. Canada trying to just get some passes going right in front. Oh, that was an opportunity. U.S. gets to it and cleared.
Amongst your top six forwards and amongst your top two units, it's so quick, a minute and a half. If you don't get something in the first 45 seconds, it's very easy to have a lot of time negated just with an icing, a broken play.
U.S. continuing to try to poke and attack. Aggressive when they get a chance on the power play or the penalty kill. And there's a... Tyler Duke doing, again, yeoman's work, as we've seen throughout group play as well. Canada with a chance. Time winding down. We are even strength right now. And oh, that just hopped over the stick of Nate Danielson. And now the U.S. Oh, there was an opportunity there for Gavin Brindley, who is an explosive goal scorer. Couldn't get his stick down in time. U.S. now in the zone and walking. Nazar lets it go. That's deflection. Oh my goodness, Nazar's third goal of the tournament. Got a couple of assists, and just like that, out of nowhere, really, even the goalie penalty, and Nazar puts the U.S. on top. And let's see what happens now. Both teams have emotions to deal with, right? Different sets of the spectrum, but both teams have to adjust now.
Yeah, it's got to be a response from Canada, but you can't push at the compromise of giving up defensively. You're going to have to keep battling one-on-one and winning your battles.
Here comes McGroarty all the way around, a twirl of Lausanne, and Fillion has that one. Oh, that was a goal scorer's goal.
Well, what a moment in this game, because that's what made me wonder. They hadn't touched the puck yet, and Lindgren was confused too. We all were. And there was no confusion there with Nazar's finish.
And can Canada answer right away? Here comes another
feature of this American offense.
And just that quickly, Canada with an opportunity to climb right back in the thick of the sauce here. Oh, and there it is. Oh, that was a wicked bounce off the boards, lively boards. And the U.S. chances for a shorthander. Oh, big save by Fillion. Manon says the... We've seen them just be explosive earlier, much earlier. But just like that, they're in charge again.
Yeah, they certainly have just grabbed this game by the throat, and it's that killer instinct. Any good team that's going to go
They got two goals in 2 minutes and 14 seconds
to defend, and that is an exceptional play made by Lane Hudson, and it gets thwarted.
Oh, big chance, and that goes way wide, not even on goal. And the U.S. now... Nice pass, and there goes Cutter Gauthier. Battling one on three, and the U.S. comes away with it. Tyler Duke wants the puck. And that's cleared all the way down. Power play over.
Of a player, I'm not saying clutching at straws, but a little desperate. But this is a better attack from Canada here.
They have a chance on the back of the net. It certainly, the fans erupted, but that was the back of the net that rattled.
They get a goal, though, here, Canada,
and
things completely change again.
Right.
So there's every part to the story. This is Fantilli, who just can't quite get full control and full composite, you'd say, nowadays, on that particular shot.
The U.S. chasing a bit. This is some good control, some good forecheck going on for Canada. Right in front. Oh, they missed again. That was Fantilli point blank.
Yeah, that's the money shot. And you got to be able to put it in the bank from there. It's not easy, but you got to get it done if you want to get back in this game.
And it's right in front, and those are scary pucks. And now the U.S. finally escapes. And you hear the USA, and this is what a setup and another.
Ahead of yourself, but that's what they're cultivating here. That's what they're developing, players, elite talent that are going to potentially have those prospects in the future.
Waning seconds of period number two. Canada desperate to get one. Well, kill the period, but they don't. Canada will get another shot, and they rip it, and the blocker aside, and that'll do it for the period. Oh, they're saying, because, yeah, there could be a medal, a big medal on the line next game, but you still have a huge period here in a Canada team that's going to throw everything at you, starting right now.
Entirely, yeah. You know, you just have to take care of the business at hand. Don't worry about the product. It'll take care of itself.
Oh, big save off of a tricky shot.
Yeah, it was. It was a little bit. Oh,
right in front, and again, Fillion has had to be ready to go in the first minute.
And that was Leno, I think, just trying to touch it down, and it's very difficult for any goalkeeper when your own defenseman is trying to bat the puck down.
A lot of ice. And U.S. coming out smartly, and oh boy, it's a big ring for some fast kids. And here comes Lane Hudson, who has absolute jets, but picked clean by the captain. We haven't seen much of Savoie. What a move there!
Fortunate for either player that they aren't injured on the play, and the nets come off quite easily.
Go 4-on-4. And Lane Hudson turns it around, and look at the U.S. on the fly again. All the way across ice, just barely off.
Very similar rangy size, left-hand shot. Big, powerful, and can really, really shoot it.
You've invoked both Canes, Patrick and Evander.
Well, there's something about it. These guys they have some of that real great game-breaking ability, some of the American shooters.
Huge moment here for Canada. Just down two, one gets it right back.
And what they can do between the whistles, and that's what the referee is trying to keep out of this game.
Their opportunity on the power play. Power play over now, right?
It's there.
And another, again. Canada now smelling it. And here they continue to buzz in front. Great back checking there. And here comes Nazar. We've seen his jets before. Backhand goes right to Canada. And here they come. End-to-end action. And oh, that was tricky. And Silverstein didn't quite get the poke check he wanted.
No, it was an awkward play, and I'm seeing Fantilli trying to get the big release off and the big shot. It's not
in front by Tyler Duke.
Yeah, it was. It's a real risk as a defenseman to try to track that.
Oh, again, it's right in front. Right in front again. Canada pouring it on. And they now have full ice tilt in their favor. And again, Silverstein having to be huge, and he is, and again, right across the goal mouth. Oh, this is an epic effort here in the third period to try to even this up. And controlling right in front, and they'll get another shot here. Oh, they're passing so well to each other.
It's 4-on-4. Canada elects as its offensive approach to dump it in. That says a little bit about their confidence to be able to carry the puck across the line.
Yeah, the U.S. having a problem getting out of their own zone. Good forecheck there from the Canadians, Matthew Savoie, who's really stepped up his game here in the third period. Now the U.S., there's Nazar. We've seen his work before.
He's a handful.
Yep. All the way back, and here he is again in possession. They'll skate it around a little bit. Look at him take on two. And they'll just decide to bring it back. The clock is their friend at this moment. 5 minutes to go. They can't lay back, but they're the ones with the lead. Full bloom for the team in white. They got to get one.
Back inside, obviously, the U.S. zone and gets the possession. But they're chasing here now. They're chasing, and the Americans are good as they've kept this one in here. This has worked out.
Just need one shot. And again, Gauthier, we just keep calling his name, always around the puck. Clears it there. And here comes Canada again.
Which I think in a minute and a half. But anyhow, we're going to see. It all depends where the puck is on the ice and who has control.
Oh, that was a nifty little backhand attempt to center it. The U.S. had it covered. They dumped it down in and out. And there's a penalty. It is all here, all now. Let's see if Canada can get one after the U.S. goes into the penalty box. And we've seen the U.S. take penalties at inopportune times earlier in the tournament. Oh, they're buzzing now. They have a two-man advantage at this point. The U.S. knows there's an empty net and it's wide, but right now the job is right in front of them. Canada cannot give up possession. Oh, and there's Fantilli. And then all the way around, they just need one. And here's the puck gets dumped in. Interesting choice not to go for the goal. They just dump it down.
Well, you just want to get it down, don't you? And Canada have had control. Really surprising, but obviously.
Again, the official.
Savoie, what's happened here?
Oh, the official has taken out two players. Savoie is hurt. They're letting it go.
This is crazy. So he was lucky, a little bit of the grace of the hockey gods, seeing him in the lineup today for Finland.
Again, to review the rules, it's 3 15-minute periods. If they remain tied, they'll go to an overtime shootout. Common penalties are 90 seconds, and that's all you need to know. It's just incredible. There's an incredible vibe in the building, and certainly for the players, first minutes are always interesting, managing the nerves and the anticipation and the opportunity right in front of them.
Well, in this game, of course, naturally, they did. They got behind to the Americans in their group stage game. They haven't had great starts in this tournament, and they'll want to be better today.
Lennon in great right there, knocks it.
Maybe, I'm not saying too casual, but you've got to make sure to be tight, not get into any bad habits, because you'll make trouble for yourself quickly in a game like this against Finland.
Is it mentally easier for Finland to just say, hey, 10-1, you know, now we move on, forget about that. And there's a rebound in that. It's not easier anymore.
No, it's not. I think we always want to level the playing field in the hopes of being both positive and optimistic for the chances of every team in competition. But right now, the Canadians have certainly started this game with a whole lot more vigor than the Finns. And if they aren't careful, this could really increase the score.
Danielson again working behind the net, and it's in front and tipped away. And maybe get one immediately to answer. That cross ice was an ambitious look, and it didn't get there. Tipped ahead, and here comes that wave of red, and it looks all too familiar for Finland. Too much red in the last 2 days.
Yeah, both the Russians and the Canadians, it's a little bit like body control too, and he's able to go in every direction, and he shoots the puck like a rocket off of his blade. He's really a lethal weapon.
And here he is trying to get in there again. There's a chance in front, and oh, that's the puck squirming around, and Fillion did well to knock that aside.
Yep, just those scrambly bouncing pucks are always difficult to manage for both teams, both the offense and the defense. And if you can settle it down quick, it's always to the better.
There's a second goal score
in this Canadian offensive lineup as this tournament has gone on.
Recap, Canada 2 goals in the first 2:48 of the game. Verrall and Danielson, and that's where we are right now, and Canada has killed off the only power play of the game so far, and there's a little feistiness, and the crowd is engaged. Canada with a chance to put a real hammerlock on this game already. Here they come in, cruising through.
So it's 4-on-4 right now, and then there will be the chance for the Canadians to go on the power play. A
lot of ice. Players love this much ice and bring out for the goalie.
Yeah, it's you got to get it done. There's no sense of standing around and allowing a guy to continue to threaten.
Yep. Fantilli, big jets, comes in. That's blocked away by the Finnish defense, and now back in front. Canada set up so nicely.
Spaces, but he also can play it in the dirty areas as well. But sometimes you just got to stop on the ice and make sure that you give your chance.
Oh, look at that. Oh, that was tricky.
Yeah, it was.
Floating through, and I think a Finnish defensive stick got in there to make it a little more difficult for Lennon in the track, but he took care of it.
Well, he can't afford to let up another one here, nope. Or their hopes of a bronze really starts to elude them.
Pressing onward, one goal here in the last 5 minutes and change would really help out Finland. Two even better.
Player, you have to get to the puck.
Oh, that was almost in. Finland showing signs. They just won with going into the break would really do a lot for their mentality. Because right now it's bleak, and they just came off a game that got.
that score line in that game against Russia. Oh, boy.
That's going to be a penalty, I would imagine. No call.
And that's one of the times. That's a big blue liner for Canada. That's Noah Warren. He's a big boy. He's 6'4" and already NHL seemingly becoming, I think, a top 2-3 defenseman on his Canadian lineup. And he's battling there as well with Ty Nelson. I think they're kind of 1-2. Yeah, of course. And you and your sauce. But 12-4, the shots. And, I mean, that's a pretty fair reflection of the score. They're out shooting him 3-1. And Finland really could have been on the board with that shot off of the draw there. But coming forward, Canada not relenting inside the last 2 minutes of this opening period.
Again, the two goals in the first 2:48 set the tone. And then you had Guidon making it three at 9:40.
I'm assuming, Tom, when you reference sauce, you're going back to your culinary days at Dakota University.
Not back. I'm a bit of a wizard in the kitchen, if I do say so myself. And sauces are my specialty. You know, there's never too much spice in my my delivery.
Well, and there's a little too much spice there. I would. Yep. You better take care of business then.
You better put the doorman out there in security and not let them in. And at this point, they've done a good job this period. There's no entrance for the team in white.
Well, they just seem to keep finding the punch bowl, don't they? And they're still there.
Again, Finland will never go away. And again, they're just one shot, one bounce from making it 3-2, and then the seeds of doubt are in full germination in the brains of the Canadians if Finland can find a way.
It's right there. I mean, this is a power play that you want to get something from, and you got to get a shot, and you got to create the sort of momentum that they're capable. There's Savoie back on the ice, who was in the penalty box for a long time.
It was.
Finland are absorbing it. They're keeping Canada to the outside where they want them.
Danielson waits, lets it go. Oh, I thought that was in, but it was just wide.
And each one of those saves, I think he gets a touch of it. It's more and more encouraging for Lennon and this Finnish team because right now they know they're in defense mode.
So while walking in, looking, letting it go, and again, wide. Off the shoulder of Lennon. And that puck goes harmlessly out of the zone. Finland will take it, and the power play is over. And 3:20 to go in the period. Can there be a... They need Roni on the ice. One of their better goal scorers, but he's watching now. And again, crucial time for Finland. They're right in this game. And Savoie. Look at Canada.
Oh, that went off the iron.
Continues to buzzed, and yeah, it went off the post. They're set up nicely. All the way around and through, and then will that clear? Yes, it will. Canada has to regroup. 30 seconds gone on the power play. Still can't clear it. Danielson with a good play there to keep it in.
Danielson has really proved himself for me to be the best Canadian forward on the ice in this game. Oh, they absorbed that last one.
Cleanly.
This is
5-on-3. And Canada take their time and get what they want. Well, Lennon way out. A heroic save. Remember that one if they're... Let nobody near his desk.
You gave me a flashback there when talking about the way outs, that famous Flintstone band.
Again, the blocker. And he's just standing on his head.
It's a shooting gallery.
It is. And he sticks off the ice. 7-6-5 on the two-man advantage. Here we go. Desperation time for Finland. Can't let this one go in. Just can't do it. We're down one now. Finland down just one.
Oh, boy, he's just sprawling everywhere.
Lennon is the hero in white for now. And again, doing business and getting feisty. He wants everybody away. Anybody in red, he's seeing red. He wants them away from his office.
Good work. And response.
And sticks it aside. And if Finland can just hold this off. They need a goal, but they certainly can't allow any more.
play.
I know they need to hear that message, but you also need to encourage them just to play to the best of their ability. They've been handpicked for a reason, because they have that characteristic, that mental makeup to perform. They just need to go out and do it.
Yeah, and tension and anxiety throughout both teams. The next goal changes the complexion of this game in a big way. And if Finland gets it, I thought Kemmel would have an opportunity right there.
I was expecting we might have to glue this building back together again.
Yep. Oh, the whistle shot again, just not a problem for Lennon, and it wasn't on goal.
Well, you've got to hit the nets, and there's the famous line, and we've heard it down, is the Canadian player.
And now
the long-term damage as a result. Look at that, though, the shots, and just watching Matejczuk as he's lined up there. It was hard for Filion to see where the shot was coming from. Defenseman, be careful not to be in the way of the goalkeeper's eyes, but nonetheless, look at that little decoy, the old round-the-world stick handle from the Finnish blue liner.
Oh, here we go. Chances right in front. They just can't put it together. But the ice tilt certainly favoring Finland at this point. They're lined up well. They've been buzzing, and they just need a bounce. And here comes Kemmel. And this man has skills like that.
Oh, boy.
What a setup. Oh, but Filion says no.
I'm not sure there's a name.
That's a nice move with the stick, and they didn't see it coming. There's a little bit of a sleep at the switch there, and now Canada can turn this in on each tier. Again, next goal changes everything. Finland, you know, you look at Just Desserts, and Finland has a sweet tooth right now. You would think that they would get one.
They'd like that chocolate mousse, I'm sure. They need to go a little bit further if they want to get a reward here today.
Yeah. Oh, boy. And there's that goal scorer, Danielson. You got to keep your eye on him. And there's Kemmel. Always have to have eyes on 13. He's a dervish. Now they're set up again. And the clock becomes the best buddy of Canada right now.
Yeah, as you get inside of 10 minutes, more so, doesn't it? And as you say, if they just get better, the defensive team holding the lead.
As you see, Filion looking and looking, and then he hears it whistle past him.
Yep, that's the challenge. And now,
here comes the captain. Oh, what a save! In it, and they are right in the thick of the sauce now.
Oh boy, this is tense times now.
No, for Canada, you're wondering a little bit, aren't you? Just a little bit.
Well, you have to raise your game.
Yep.
You've got to be the better team on the ice. If you're not going to be the better team of the two on the ice, you won't win.
And there's Fantilli. Hops over his skate. He would sorely have loved to have a shot there. Oh, the Finns are buzzing. I would say Finns up fully. Fully Finns up.
Yeah, with the amount of buzzing that they've been providing today, well, you're expecting that there's going to be a result.
It's a power play for Canada and a huge penalty kill opportunity for Finland, and this could be the telling moment for Canada. It's right there, and you see the puck just has eyes, but not for Canada at the moment. There's a big hit, they'll let that go. Fantilli again run. He's trying to make up for it. Look at the wraparound, no call. There's Kemmel. He can't clear it. But let's see. Yes, that is full credit to Finland. They've come through the juggernaut. The USA got them early and held on. Then they had to work their way past Switzerland. And then, of course, they've absorbed the thrashing from... Doesn't win it, but the puck is there to be had, and it's Finland. Kemmel lets it go. Oh, it's not in. Look at them, patient. I love the poise. No panic from Finland. Laxa lets it go. No rebound. Oh, it's a 2-on-1. It could be over for Finland. Empty net.